Governor Yahya Bello is one of the youngest governors we have in this country. And in the history of Nigeria politics, what Yahya Bello is doing has never happened anywhere in this country. From his commissioners, all the cabinet members, most of the appointees are youth. So his government is youth-oriented government. So the youth are 100% with him. We're giving him all the necessary support he deserves to make sure that he deliver all the required economic or what is expected of his government. But again, one thing I can assure you, with his presence, people like of our age can never come out to say they want to contest for any political election. Before now, it used to be an old carcass of a thing. But with what we have today, over 99% of the aspirants, including those that couldn't make it, they were all youth. Issue of salary is very critical to every state, not only Kogi State. And of course, being a stakeholder in the state government, because when I said I'm a stakeholder, I don't necessarily need to be an appointee in the government or to be a civil servant. As a concerned citizen, there are ways you can advise the government in areas you felt they are not doing well, you understand, because no leader can have it 100% or as excellently. But of course, with the little he's doing, we have to keep telling him that, okay, Your Excellency, in social area, there are some gaps, you know, and there is need for him to close up those gaps. You know, talking about IGR, the internally generated revenue, is a very serious matter. And as a state government, if you want to deliver the dividends of democracy to your state that you govern, you have to pay serious attention to your IGR, especially states that have considering the meager allocation that come from the federal government. So, and I told you, you know, the initial, I think it was around 350 to 500 million in the government of the previous government. But recently I heard it was over 1 billion now. And these are some of the area we need to commend him. But not just commending, but how to appropriately utilize those available money, it's also another issue, like the issue of salary you just asked me about. The government will come up with better plans to see that, okay, now this is what we get from the federal government as an allocation, and this is what we generate as a state. So, and what is the total cost of the wages or salary in the state, and how much can go to them, you understand? And mind you, on this same issue of salary, if you remember, the previous governor, the government that were there, they were paying percentage. I don't know if you have that. So this to tell you that truly there are some genuine issues on ground that has to do with funds, you understand? That is the available resources to the state government. But of course, where people are negative-oriented-minded people begin to only look at the negative aspect of the government, what do you expect? A complete failure. But where you also look at some areas they have performed, you need to advise. Of course, the government will take your advice. Then, of course, you know, Ajokuta is one of the second largest steel company in Africa, if I'm not mistaken, or the world at large, based on the information available. But that company have been lying down for years. Nothing is happening there. You understand? And this is a facility that can provide employment to millions of youth in Kogi State and some other neighboring states. You understand? Even Nigeria at large, it's a very big company. Although I'm happy, recently I saw it on the paper, the Minister of Mines and Steel Development were inviting a competent contractor to come and bid for the rehabilitation of that Ajokuta state. So these are some of the dividends of democracy. I think with that, there will be a lot of improvement in terms of economic in the state.